All right, here we go. We're going to start on our new chapter, and you're going to be learning about ancient Rome. So this will be our last chapter. Sorry again that I can't be with you, but I trust that you have your lecture notes ready to go, and you're ready to take some notes. Let's start with the let's start with the focus questions. So our first focus question is, number one, who were the earliest people of the Roman civilization? The answer is the Latins. The Latins were a group of people from Central Europe, and they moved down into the Italian peninsula. So the Latins were the earliest group of people that started the Roman civilization. Our second question is, what are some of the ways the patricians improved the way of life for the Romans? The patricians introduced a system of writing based on the Greek alphabet. They made improvements to the city by paving roads, building arches, draining marshes, and constructing a sewage system. I'm going to say this one more time. You'll see this question two more times after this, so you know what that means. So the answer is, they introduced a writing system, made improvements to the city by paving roads, building arches, draining marshes, and constructing a sewage system. If you need to pause the video so that you can write that down, you can. Like I said, we'll be coming back to this question two more times. This is an extremely famous saying: all roads lead to Rome. Make note of it. All roads lead to Rome. Why? Because when the Romans were expanding, they built roads throughout their entire empire, and this helped to connect their empire. Remember when we were learning about Alexander the Great, we noticed that his empire was huge, but he was going to have a hard time controlling his empire because it was so big. But with the Romans and the roads, that made it easy for them to control their empire. Let's look at a map real quick, and I want you to see how many modern countries the Roman Empire actually covered up. So here's our map. This is basically what the Roman Empire looked like. It went from Spain to France to Italy, down here to Greece, over to Turkey, down around Israel, and across the top of the African continent. So all of these countries over here have Roman influences in them. So all roads lead to Rome because they do. The Roman Empire lasted for approximately 507 years, which is from 31 BC to 476 AD. And we're going to be learning about that more in later parts of this chapter. All right, I'm going to give you a moment to write down all of these things, but make sure you leave room in between them because you're going to want to add things to each of the words. So pause the video, write down this slide. All right, we've already talked about the Latins and that they lived on the Italian peninsula. So the early Latins were searching for fertile soil and a climate that was more suitable for farming. So they traveled across the Alps, which border the top part of the Italian peninsula, and started heading south. And they settled on the Italian peninsula near the Tiber River. If you look in your textbook, you'll see a map that shows where the city of Rome ended up being at. If you've noticed, almost all of the ancient civilizations that we've studied started near a river. Sumer started near a river, Egypt started near a river, and now Rome is starting near a river. Think about it. The river provides drinking water, food, transportation, and it helps the farmland to be fertile. Now, let's talk about what a legend is. A legend is a story about historical events that are passed down from generation to generation. They're told as truth, but most likely they're not actually true. This would be similar to things that we've learned about already, an epic, a myth, or traditions. Now there's a legend that goes along with the story of the founding of Rome. And that legend has to do with two people named Romulus and Remus. Romulus and Remus were twin brothers. You read about this in your chapter. And they, one murdered the other, kind of like the story of Cain and Abel. And they ended up starting the civilization of Rome. That's not how historians really believe that Rome was actually founded. They believe it was founded on Palatine Hill, one of the seven hills that surround the city of Rome, and on the western side of the Italian peninsula near the Tiber River. The city of Rome is still there today. Now let's move on to the Etruscans. So this group of people conquered the Latins, and during their reign, they improved several things. You should know the answer to this. They introduced a writing system based on Greek. They improved the city by paving the roads, building arches, draining marshes, and constructing a sewage system. The Etruscans improved the life of the Latins by introducing a writing system based on Greek, improving the city by paving the roads, building arches, draining marshes, and constructing a sewage system. And last thing on this slide are the two social classes of the ancient Romans. So, first of all, the patricians. You need to make note that the patricians were mostly the ruling class, wealthy landowners and nobles. Patricians, ruling class, wealthy landowners, nobles. Patricians, ruling class, wealthy landowners, nobles. Now let's talk about the plebeians. This is the working class. The plebeians were common people, farmers, traders, and craftsmen. The plebeians, working class, common people, farmers, traders, craftsmen. Plebeians. Working class, common people, farmers, traders, and craftsmen. I do want to point out to you, there are only two social classes, which means you're either in one or the other. There was no middle class like we think of in our culture today. You were either rich or you weren't. One thing these two groups of people had in common, the patricians and the plebeians, were both hardworking and they valued freedom and self-government. If you need to go back and listen to who was included in the patricians and the plebeians, I encourage you to do that. All right. Couple quick questions and then we'll go down to the dig and drill. What were the early Latins searching for as they migrated across the Alps? Better farmland. They wanted to find a better place to farm. Second, what were the advantages of Rome's location? Rome was near water. It's located on high ground because there are seven hills that surround the city. And third, it was protected by the Alps to the north part of Italy. And third, I told you you would see this question three times. What did the attritions introduce during their reign? Let's say it together. Writing system based on Greek. They paved the roads of the city. They built arches, drained marshes, and constructed a sewage system. We've seen it three times. I hope you realize it's important. All right, dig and drill. According to the legends, the twins blank and blank decided to build a city near the Tiber River to commemorate their place of rescue. And that would be Romulus and Remus. Last question. The two social classes of the Roman people were called the blank and the blank. The patricians and the plebeians.